What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about cross-linking projects in Revit. So when it comes to linking projects in Revit, I think it's really important to cross-link your projects because that's going to allow you to make sure that everything kind of corresponds correctly, and when you make changes to either one of the models, the other one will be kind of adapted to that new change. So I'm just going to be giving you an example on a kind of a practical example on a building and a site. So I'm going to be linking up the building project with a site project, and we're going to be talking and showing how cross-linking works in Revit and what's the workflow there. Now before we jump into that, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I have over 136 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. That's where I kind of take the extra time to go slowly, step by step, and cover all of Revit's complex topics, ranging from beginner to intermediate, as well as advanced level topics. Also there you can find some of my customized Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, as well as a plugin. So make sure to check it out. Also make sure to like this video. It helps me out a lot. And also make sure to subscribe. Not only does it help you not miss any of my future videos, it also makes the alpaca happy. And come on, guys, let's make the alpaca happy. Okay, now with that out of the way, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see here, I have this Revit model. This is actually a building that I show you how to build in my beginner to intermediate level course that's on my website. So if you're interested, it's there. And before we get started, I just want to show you kind of a little tip here. If you've been working with Revit 2020, the earlier version, and then if you try to open up a model in later versions, you're going to get this little kind of icon here, the project origin or something like that. I kind of can't remember the name. But anyways, if this is annoying to you, you can easily turn it off by simply going to your view properties. You can go to visibility graphics overrides. You can scroll down to, I think, site. Expand that, and here we have, yeah, it's called the internal origin. And if you hit apply and okay, it's just going to turn that off, and now I think everything looks a lot better. Okay, now I'm going to be linking up this with a site project. So you just want to go here to insert, then you want to go to link Revit, and then you want to find that file. So just give me a second for that. Here it is. So I want to use the office building site. I'm just going to hit open, and it's actually going to kind of fit in perfectly because I've already set it up. And if you want to learn more about how to correctly kind of set up the coordinates and locations of the link, I covered that in this course, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, so you can check it out there. But anyways, once this has been kind of set up, now what I want to do is I just want to see how everything kind of fits in. So for example, here I can already notice that this site here has this kind of building pad below that, and it's kind of overlapping with this floor that I have here in the project. So I can just go ahead and delete that floor because I don't want to have kind of overlapping geometry. So that's something that we have there. Also here I can see that we have an issue where kind of this landscape would kind of fall off into the building, and here the other side here you can see it's covering the window a little bit. So we do have some issues that we want to fix in the actual site project here. So what you want to do for that is you want to go here and save this model, and then you just want to close it. And then you want to open up the other one, the site project. So you want to close up the original project because Revit will not allow you to link something up when it's already opened up in Revit. So that's just something to keep in mind. So anyways, we're now here in the site project. Again, we can turn off this ugly thing by going to visibility graphics overrides, going to site, and then turning off the internal origin. Okay, perfect. Now again, it's as simple as going to insert Revit link, and then it's going to be the office building one, hit open, and it's just going to open up that project there. And now we can make some changes. So for example, here you can see we have this building pad. Let's see if I can select it. There we go. We have this building pad, and I can notice that here we have some extra space. I don't like the shape of it. Perhaps I can go to edit boundary, and then in the site plan, I can make some changes. So let's go like this. Let's make it a spline. I'm just going to go like this. Now, if you want to go perhaps to this point and then to this one, don't click exactly on the line because that's going to kind of stop the spline. See? But if you just go to spline and then you click here and then click here, you can see it's going to allow you that additional click. So you just don't want to click on a line unless it's kind of the final point of your spline. That's kind of a little extra tip. So anyways, let's kind of connect this. Okay, we can say we're happy with this shape, for example. We can say finish. There we go. So we have made some changes. And then also we want to make some changes to the topography itself. So I can select the topography, go to edit surface. Let's place some points. I'm just going to use relative to surface. Place one there, and then one here, and then I can bring this down a little bit. So this is it. Okay, let's try zero, maybe a little less, so minus 0.1. Okay, that works. And then for this one, this is minus 0.7. There we go. So now everything is kind of fitting in perfectly. Okay, and now let's hit finish. Now, let's say we want to have kind of a little balcony here. Perhaps the building would kind of exit onto a little flat area here. So for that, what I would want to do is go to the site plan, and then let's add a little balcony there. So let's go to massing and site. I'm going to do it by using a building pad at level 1 with no offset. And then we can just use a kind of a rectangle tool and just create, I don't know, just something like this. Hit finish, go to the 3D view. So that would look kind of somewhat like this. Obviously, we can kind of play around with points. We can go place some points, I don't know, like this around that. And then place some points here around the actual building pad. Like so. So when you do this, just going for an extra little tip, you can select all of these points and then set them to elevation of 0. See, and now we have that kind of lifted up a little bit. Now that you look at it, perhaps they should be at minus 0.1. There we go. So now this looks a lot better. See how now our topography kind of flows into that balcony. But now we have an additional problem where we don't have a door on our project. So now what we have to do is save this, close it up, and then open up that office building project again. I'm just dragging it over from a second folder. And then here what I would do is, see here, now we have that balcony. When you make changes to the link and then you open up the project again, it will automatically update that link. So that's basically just something to keep in mind. And then we can come here, we can go to level 1, we can zoom in here to, I don't know, perhaps this panel, unpin that and turn it into a door panel. I don't know, something like that. And now as you can see here, we have a door that kind of comes to this little patio or whatever you want to call this surface that we have here. So that's basically how you work by cross-linking and then working back and forth, going from the main model to the link or from the site plan to the building. And that's how you make progress working on projects such as this one. So just the kind of the main important thing is make sure to close up the actual project when you're opening it up and when you're linking it up with a different one. And that's pretty much it. The rest is really kind of up to you, and you can kind of start playing around with that. So I hope you have learned something new. I hope you you enjoyed this video. Please tell me in the comment section below, do you have perhaps a different workflow? Do you have some of your own tips and tricks? And also, if you want to get this exact project file, you can find that on my Patreon page. So I am going to be linking that up in the description of this video and then also up in the cards above, so you can get it there. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.